good, good.
All right, so today you're actually going to be able to experience these TSS functions as well. I believe the wind is down at El Toro, so you're going to be able to experience the vehicle pre-collision system, a pedestrian pre-collision system, the full-speed cruise control DRCC. So I highly encourage you on your first stop today at El Toro to take advantage of that. We have about four engineers here to show you those systems and explain them. So let's talk about Toyota Safety Sense first. Toyota Safety Sense was brought out and we announced it around April in New York International Auto Show. What it is an active safety technology package that's anchored by pre-collision system warning and braking. And it really is meant to prevent three types of collisions. It's meant to prevent frontal collisions or rear-ending someone. It's also meant to keep drivers from unintentionally departing from their lanes, and also to improve visibility at nighttime. So those are three types of accidents that this is meant to address. And with Toyota's philosophy, with a lot of OEMs, is that crash protection really starts with crash prevention. And that's what these systems are going to do. So let's talk about each one of them really quickly. For TSS, we're going to have two different packages, and all of this is in your PR outline as well. We have one specifically for TSS, so all this information is there. So TSS-C and TSS-P are two of our systems. One is for more compact cars, and one is for a midsize and up. Ultimately, they function almost the same. Pre-collision system for vehicles is found on both of these systems. It works from speeds of 7 to 50 miles an hour for TSS-C, and it works from 7 to the vehicle's top speed for TSS-P because it has a different radar on it. Ultimately, it's going to give you a warning first if a potential collision could occur, an audible and a visual. At that point, if the driver were to brake, but maybe not brake enough for the condition, the brake assist may kick in and give you full braking and power. If the customer were to not do any braking and a potential collision was even higher, then automatic emergency braking would kick in certain conditions and slow that vehicle. It's meant to mitigate the collision in most cases and prevent it in some. Lane departure alert is going to be found on both the C and the P packages. What this does is it uses our in-vehicle camera and it's going to detect visibly marked lanes with the white and yellow lane markers. Once a lane is visibly detected on one or both sides, the system would provide alerts if you were about to unintentionally depart from that marked side. So if you had your turn signal on, obviously that's going out, so it's not going to do anything. But in the case where you unintentionally depart, it would give you an audible and a visual warning. On the TSS-P vehicles, you update that a little bit. We're going to get a steering assist function that's added on our TSS-P vehicles that have electric power steering, which is the majority of them. So what will happen on this is beyond the audible and visual alert, you'll also get a slight steering correction for a slight moment in time to put you back in the lane. This is not like other systems, even on the Lexus side, that do lane centering, where it functions with dynamic radar and keeps you kind of centered in a lane. This is just to put you back into the lane if you're about to unintentionally depart. Auto high beams is going to be found on both systems. Very simply put, it's the same system we've had for a few years now. It's going to look for preceding headlights, taillights, road signs. Ultimately, if it sees that, it's going to drop you from high beams to low beams so you're not dazzling the other vehicles in front of you. And as soon as those lights are gone, it pops back up with the high beams, so it allows the driver to see more of what's ahead on the side of the road and on the dark highway, possibly, where you wouldn't have to do it automatically or manually switching back and forth. So it makes driving easier and makes visibility the most you can have by looking for what's ahead. That's on both systems. Now, going on to what's only on TSS-P vehicles. So pre-collision system with pedestrian detection function is added on the TSS-P vehicles. And this is going to function much the same as our pre-collision system for vehicles, in that it'll provide you an audible and a visual warning if a pedestrian is walking in front of your vehicle. And at that point, if the driver were to brake but not enough, brake assist could occur. And if they don't brake at all in certain conditions, automatic emergency braking would take place. Now, for potential collisions with vehicle or with a pedestrian, it's going to function from 7 to 50 miles an hour. And I'm not saying like if you go under 7, it stops, but you have to be going at least 7 miles an hour originally for the system to do the braking function. And at that point, it will bring the vehicle down, mitigate the collision, and in some cases, prevent that. another system, just like Heather mentioned, is that dynamic radar cruise control or adaptive cruise controls out there on the P versions only. And that's highly due to the fact that the P system uses an in-vehicle camera, but ultimately it has a millimeter wave radar on the front of the vehicle. So it has the ability to detect further out, and that helps it with the distances. That's why this P system can do this. Our C system just uses a camera and a laser mounted in the car. It's meant for shorter distance, lower speeds. But ultimately, that millimeter wave radar is what gives you the ability to do this. And she already mentioned that the Prius would be the only one that does full range or full speed. The other vehicles stop at about 25 to 28 miles an hour. You have to go back over that to resume DRCC.